Now I want to go way back to 1992, the year Nirvana's Nevermind went number one on the U.S. Billboard 200 chart. Sinead O'Connor stirred up controversy by ripping a picture of the Pope on Saturday Night Live. You remember that? And Bill Clinton defeated George Bush in the presidential election. But before all that happened, this happened on my show. That was then Arkansas Governor Bill Clinton belting out a soulful rendition of Heartbreak Hotel on my show, the Arsenio Hall Show, that changed presidential campaigning forever. Now, he played the sax, and people say it changed things forever, but I don't want to be the one saying that. So I got Mr. John King, CNN's John King here, and we're going to talk about that memorable time. And, John, if you're there, let's discuss how it changed things. Do you think it changed politics forever?
Without a doubt, it changed politics forever. Remember, Clinton was in a lot of trouble that year. There were a lot of character questions. It was also a fascinating, unusual presidential race. Ross Perot was a factor in that race as well. So what was the challenge? Number one, for Bill Clinton to expand the definition of his personality when there were a lot of character questions and other questions about whether this guy from Arkansas was ready to do this. Number two, the challenge was reach out to try to get new voters. Perot was bringing new voters into the process. Clinton wanted to bring new voters into the process. So we always talk about, you know, Howard Dean campaigning on the Internet, Barack Obama reaching out to younger voters. Well, that's the seed of it right there in the new television age of getting outside of the traditional news programs, taking a risk. Taking a risk, Arsenio. Good politicians take a risk. And Clinton took one there. And you remember, I was a print reporter at the time covering that campaign. A lot of people criticized him. A lot of people said this is not presidential. He won the election. So by definition, it worked.